Welcome to the TV Tactics tutorial covering monitoring, the feature which tells you who is under attack, who has changed tribes, who has become barbarian, and much more. One of the most interesting buttons in TV Tactics is the Download Latest TV Data button, this one right here. After downloading a new snapshot, TV Tactics will load the current and previous snapshots, and you can look at some interesting reports on the things that happened between them. So right now we're on the map tab, we're going to the monitoring tab, and right here we can see we're comparing the current with 8th of November 2011. You can see here there is a difference of 4 days and 18 hours between them. So all reports are the things that happened between those 4 days. When we select a different date here, for example the one below is 382 days ago, there will be a much larger difference between the two snapshots. So let's look at some pre-made filters. First one is the new inactive villages, where we can see the old owners, or those are the players that have become barbarian between those 4 days. We can also see which villages have lost points, where we can see some players in blue. These are players within your tribe. And here we can see how many points each village has lost. So for example, this barbarian village has lost 256 points, so someone has knocked down the wall. You can also see which villages have been nobled within these 4 days. And then we can also see some reports for players. For example, players who have not gained any points in the 4 days between the snapshots. So some players are so inactive that people already noticed and they're being nobled as we speak. Some other players are inactive but no one has noticed because they haven't lost any points. You can also see which players have changed tribes, so you can see the old tribe and the new tribe. You can quickly monitor who's hopping, tribe hopping, etc. And then you can see some filters about your tribe, so the players, some default stuff about the players in your tribe, how many villages have they gained, how many villages have they lost, how many points have they gained, etc. So a possibility here is to increase the snapshot time. So if you click left click here, it will now it's a difference of 300 of over a year. So if you change, if you click the your tribe players now, there's a much bigger difference. In this year, Agile has gained 475 villages. Of course, in this year also, a lot more people have become inactive. The list is also interactive, so you can left click on it, and it will select a village. Or you can double click on it, and it will select a village and go to it. Also here, the eyes mean the village is currently visible on your main map. So if you click on a different one, you can see how it changes in the minimap. It's a blinking cross. Also, right click is also possible, so you can start a new attack plan, or you can let's find another list. Or you can also do something with the owner of the village. You can change his color or do stuff. Alright. If you're unhappy with the pre-made filters, it's also possible to customize the filter. You check the checkbox, and whenever you select one of the pre-made filters, it changes the values right here. But once you have clicked the custom filter, you can change things yourself. So for example, you can say I want to see all villages that have lost points, but I want them only within this tribe, or I want them to be in a different area. For example, now you can choose the visible map, which is only a search in what's visible right now, so not on the mini map but on the main map. It's right there. We can search the entire map, we can search in the monitored area. By default, the monitored area is the entire map, but you can change it. So you can change the area what you want to monitor. So let's try that right now. We're going back to the map. we're going to some small player. All right, there he is. So now it's still the different snapshots have a time of 1 year between them. So a lot has changed for this player. In fact, all these white circles are villages that he owned 1 year ago and still owns today. All yellow circles are villages he has taken over, and all red circles are villages that he used to have, but he has lost in the meantime. Also, if you check the tooltip text, to also say how many points the village has increased from by who it's snowballed or who it's snowballed from. So this was an abandoned village that has been nobled. Can also see for this player how many villages he has, how many villages he has gained, and how many villages he has lost. But now to set the monitoring rectangle, we will zoom a bit out, for example, like this. Then there's a button here for set the monitoring area. When you click it, get a magenta rectangle, and you can now select the area you want to monitor. You can use the plus and the minus to increase or decrease the size of the monitoring area. So let's, for example, take this one with left click. We confirm. Now we are automatically back to the monitoring tab, and if you're looking at all new inactive villages, it's still a lot. Let's change it back to the 4th of November. So in these 4 days, now it's only two villages, while on the entire map. Oh, apply additional filters. Sorry. So when we apply additional filters, you see from all the map, now is it only for the monitored area. Alright, I think that's about it for monitoring. I hope you find it useful and see you later.